Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Check out the link in my description for 10% off your first purchase.
Now, as many of you guys know, I've been a photographer and filmmaker for the past 5 or 6 years. I've been doing it since middle school, got really involved in high school, and now I'm continuing it throughout college. Now, a question that I get asked a lot is how to start your own photography business and how to start making money from it. Something that you're passionate about and you wanna, you know, make a few extra bucks on the side. As a student, I totally understand that. So today I'm gonna be giving you guys my tips on how I started my own photography business in the Dallas area, what you need, the connections that you'll need to make, and everything that you'll need to know, because that's something that's not often talked about, and especially as a student, it's hard to get your name out there and especially show people that you're credible and that you still have really good talent as a young photographer. So without further ado, let's cue that intro. Alright, I just turned on these lights. But anyway, the first and most important step is that you need to practice, and you need to practice for cheap. When you're first starting out, you're gonna be making very little money, if any at all. Obviously, you're not gonna be able to make the big bucks of $200, $300 because you don't have enough reputation, you don't have enough credibility to show people that I am an established photographer and that I can charge these rates. What I personally recommend and what I did was just go on photo shoots with your friends. Don't think of it as I'm building my portfolio or anything like that. Just be like, I'm just trying to get better at photography, which should be the main goal and should be the main purpose that you're doing it. Now, my photography today obviously didn't get to where it came from out of nowhere. It took months, if not years, of practice to become the photographer I am today, and I'm constantly trying to improve, which is why I think that practicing as much as you can is the best route. Don't worry so much about the pricings or the rates or the quotes or anything like that. Just focus on getting better and developing your craft before you start to charge some rates. Now, the second most important thing is, like I said, build a portfolio. This is probably one of the most critical, if not most important, part of establishing yourself as a photographer and making your own business. Nowadays, the fastest and easiest way to get clients is to show people your portfolio and show them the work that you've done so that they know that you're credible and that you're reputable and that you have great work that you can show them. Nowadays, there are dozens of different ways to host a portfolio, but the one that I personally use and recommend is Squarespace. You've most likely heard about them before because nowadays everyone seems to be hosting their website with Squarespace. The reason that everyone's been raving about Squarespace lately is because it's so simple to use. It's very user-friendly and all the features are super intuitive. Right now, I'm in the process of redesigning my own website and I'm constantly amazed of just how easy it is to upload pictures, change the gallery style, change every little thing that you could think about on a website. It's so easy to do. I've also worked for other companies and helped them build their own websites, and I always build it using Squarespace. And like I said, it's so easy to use that once I set it up for them, I just have to walk them through of how to use it and they can manage it on their own from there. I personally had no coding experience and none of that was necessary because they have so many drag and drop features that you don't need any of that. Another great thing is that they have an e-store already integrated within the platform. So if you ever want to sell your prints, it's already easy to do. I personally use it to use my ebooks, and they also have an app on my phone that I can track the analytics, which makes everything super seamless. And now if you hit that link in my description, you guys can get 10% off your first purchase. So I highly recommend getting yourself a domain, hosting your website, and building your portfolio, because as soon as you have a professional looking portfolio, the amount of clients you're going to be receiving is just going to exponentially increase. So I highly recommend making that investment right now and go check out that link in my description. Okay, now the third thing is to have consistent rates. When you're building a photography business and having clients come to you asking how much do you charge, how much is a wedding, how much is an event, how much are senior photos, how much is family photos, you can't be just throwing out random numbers that you feel like pulling out of nowhere. You have to have some kind of consistent rate, whether it's on your website or by the hour or just a flat rate, so that clients know that you're professional, that you're consistent, and that you're not ripping people off by charging, you know, $300 for one person or $150 because they're your friends. This can also get into tricky territory when you're working for friends or close family members, because then you're not exactly so sure of how much to charge them. But if you have a consistent rate, it just makes things a lot easier and they understand, because you're an entrepreneur, you're trying to start your own business, and they should be supporting that as well. However, when you're figuring out your rates, don't forget to take into account things like editing time, the transportation, if you need to rent some equipment. All that should factor into the final price of how much you're going to be quoting your customer. Which leads me to my next point of contracts and invoices. I didn't do this when I was starting out photography, and I think that's a huge rookie mistake and something that I wish I would have done from the beginning, because it would have saved me so much hassle. In the long run, having a contract will be such a lifesaver, because it lays out every single thing that you as a photographer are in charge of and them as a client are responsible for paying once the deliverables have been received. That way you don't have any problems of, oh, you're supposed to send me 30 photos instead of 20 photos, or do I have the copyright for all these images? Can I post these anywhere? Like, if you lay that all out in your contract, it will just make it a seamless workflow. Now, invoices are also important because they allow you to charge the customer the rate that you guys agreed on, and so that they have it for their own filing purposes and you can use it for your own filing purposes as well, especially if you need to do taxes later on. Now, number 5 is customer service. What I mean by that is your work is only as good as your reputation, especially if you're working in a small town, in a small neighborhood where a lot of people might get to know your name and you're the only photographer, then being a good photographer isn't the only thing that matters. It's also about being a good person. So, you know, being accommodating with someone's schedule, if they need to reschedule because of the weather or they're really not feeling well, like, be accommodating of that, and I promise that's just gonna make your life so much easier as well. Now, obviously, you are a photographer and you are a creative professional, either trying to make it as a living or, like I said, as a side hustle, but at the same time, your clients need to be respectful of your time as well and realize that our job isn't just to have a fancy camera and to hold it up and take a few pictures and then just go in and throw a filter on. Like, there's so much more that goes into the whole process of having a photography business. All right, I hope you guys have enjoyed this and I was able to shed some light on how to start your own photography business. You know, as a young kid and an entrepreneur and a photographer, like, I understand the difficulties of starting your own business. So I hope that this was able to clarify things a little bit. I know I haven't been doing as many photography or film videos lately, but I am trying to get back into them. So I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.